but out of Bytica, that is a software to draw lines and graphical stuff. And it's only a 2D drawing card, not a 3D drawing card. And this is my story. How I met Bytica and how I met Bytica with Bytica together. We are now at release 38 and in the alpha stage of 5. Before going to a new release, we build some alpha stage to have the release stable, and then when it is not stable, we go on with the release. So this one, the R38, was the first release that we made with the Qt user interface instead of JDK. So it's a very, very big revolution for us. So let's start. I will talk just a bit of it. It was me when I was very, very young. And I met the first time it was a complexity computer. So I'm very proud of that computer because I started playing around with games. But after a few games, as you know, when we started this computer, we had a type, so we had to wait a long time to load the game, so it was quite bored. So, at the same time, I met a common prompt where I can just make some random stuff on it. And I started learning something about games and the little database on this computer, and for me, it was the first time that I met this. I want just to remember this. Of course, my games in my database was not very nice. It doesn't work at all, but I tried to do my best. Even in my career, I just learned a few basic Fortran at the school, in my study. And then, when I started to work, I just learned BB6 and C#. And GPL, that is a graphical language, a property language from the company that was working on. It was very, very interesting stuff, but all these programs are not free enough. So there is someone behind that developed and enforced how you have to do stuff and so on. So, and all of these programs, except in the compiler, so I was very, very bored about that, because I needed to wait time to do my stuff, and you know, the bugging process was very long. So, of course, I'm lazy people, the person. So, I'm looking around and to have some program that are free and usable, and let me just type the code and see what's happening. Like, I just it would be six, but without the need of an entire system like for studio. So, hopefully, I found Python, and I found that Python was also cross-platform. At that time, but when I know Python, I even know Debian, the language distribution, the famous, and the great means of, the great thing of Debian, that is that all the packets must be totally open source. So I found like a friend in that. And I start to work with Linux and Python together, even for Microsoft and Linux. So Python makes me happy because I can do a program in Linux and then run it play on Windows. Of course, you know, sorry. So another thing that I learned was ABTK search. And the first, I learned Debian. I was working for a tech company that made a account, and the first package that I was looking for was a cat package. So I found their particle, and I look at it and say, okay, the user interface was not very, very nice, but the features are all there. So maybe with some help that I can give to the project, I can just give my contribution and improve the functionality of the product. Of course, I love Python. As I told you, I work on the CAD company. So, all these things came together to me, and I started with PythonCAD. Just a little bit of story. PythonCAD was first developed by pronounced, I don't know the pronunciation, that was the first mediator, and the work began was in 2002. He worked sadly, and he had the first release of 21 of 2002. And he was a lot until 2007. So, as you can see, he built the 26 release. So, how it worked? It was a CAD with the GTK client interface. There was no support for extra format like ESF and DWG. Not at all. It was something written in the code, but nothing exposed to the user interface, so the user can't directly export to this format. So you have an XML file format. You store all the data into an XML file format. And there was at the time a public repository to make any contribution of the solution. So, and it was, I mean, I met some Python in 2009. And there was no commit for 2 years, so there is nothing that is dead. It was dead, completely dead. Okay, so let's have a quick look at how the problem goes.
More visibility and to get more developers help me
say, I would, the task was to create a dynamic group, so something that let me just go around the zoo very fast. So after that, I say, the structure 9 are not giving up. It takes too long to go. So why not put on there some stamp functionality? I know all this stuff because I was inside the CAD company, so I used to teach the people how to draw 2D, 3D. So I know quite well how what the customer needs for drawing. So I started working on it, and then I released the first R37 version. That was named after 2 years of being completely inactive. So I don't remember after how many months I published, but it don't take too much to build all that stuff. So after that, as I saw in Debian, was the repository. I still have the source code in there and the package. I just keep in touch with the maintainer and asked him to include the R37 inside the Debian package. So, okay, let's see. My job at that time. As you can see, if you make apt-get install Python tab, the application will directly inside Office and you can have it. I found some people that built for me the icons, so looked more Python style icons, so we made that. And is a C, the C is a, sorry. Is the new one, the A. So as you can see the difference between the two products now. Now is there's still no toolbar at all. We have some discussion because some user don't want toolbar at all. You say, oh, you don't need it, maybe it's better than keyboard button. So that time it wasn't very, very important. But the first time I split the menu. So before the menu, the human functionality was inside the modify, then I just gave the proper place to all the zooming stuff and so on. So now working with the package was more easy because we can just do something and just make some stuff like that. So okay. And even I made all of the snap functionality. So as you can see, when I pass through this, I need to activate a command before, and after that, as soon as I go near some line and so on, he brought me change the cursor of the mouse and just show you what it's going to do. So in this case, get the middle point of the line. And even more complex stuff like emergency are allowed. So, if you go here, just map and go to tangent, you can go here or there. And as you can see, the map is very good. Like, it's nice. It's amazing. Okay, so we have all this functionality. But, and even so, I didn't show you, but it works with the other version. There, you have the dimension functionality here. You can, of course, make modification like move horizontal, vertical, stretch the entity, split entity, rotate, length, change the style, color style, so on. So, there's a lot of stuff that I didn't make this, it was already there. Okay. Go back to the slide. But not all the things shine nice, and something happened. I am the developer team, you guys comes and say, okay, I want you to do something important. I say, oh, great, very nice. And they start to work on that. But as soon as we have this functionality ready, we get some trouble. Because a lot of very huge drawings, even little drawings, make our trouble, and we noticed a lot of trouble. The first was a performance issue. As soon as I made some final operations and preparation, the program stopped working well. So, make some stuff like that. There was not a good things for a CAD package. So, what to do right now? We make a little brainstorming on that, and we start thinking where was the issue. The issue, we say, okay, GPK maybe could be the issue. No, GPK was not the issue. So we changed GPK, but not for GPK itself, but because GPK forced us to do some stuff to render the entity in the program. So the problem was that each time we move, we make plan operation, simulation operation, we look with Python to all the dictionary of the entity, and we put all these things into the GPK client. So each time you plan, each time you move the mouse on the screen, Python start looking. For a lot of entities, it's very, very complex. And even we get some memory issue due to the XML format file. So if you use program, when we load this this file, the memory goes up, and we don't really understand why we get this kind of trouble. So someone say only C++ is good enough for a CAD package, but I don't believe it. And I say, okay, let's have a look at what we have around in the world. And we say, oh, we have Cairo is quite nice, and lots of great functionality. So, and even have a new idea that was to make a picture of the drawing entity inside of the canvas. Okay, I'm going to move this picture like a kid does. And we say, okay, that's nice, because we make a picture, we just, when the user finished to make his movement, we re-render again the entity on the screen. But it works very well for the pan operation, but makes me trouble when we made some zoom operation, that we need to scale the entity. So you need again to re-render each time and start looping again to render exactly the entity inside the screen. So can you we spent 1 month on that. And we hired that to the American guys, it was a Holland guy, started to test the WX Python. But the WX Python have we like it a lot because it's free, there is no problem with that. And it's really open source, and it's easy for doing interface and so on. But have the same problem that GPK has. So, we start in parallel, K-Inter and IPT. I start with K-Inter and I called the other guys, the other guys start with IPT. And we achieved before the results with IPT, so we just IPT on for that. There is no way, they have both the same functionality, so they can, they handle properly all the display list of the entity. So we don't need to take care of the display list of the entity. We just put the entity there and they manage everything. Zooming operation, pump operation, and it's a C++ or C. I don't know how big it is, but so we have a very, we go very, very fast with this. So after reaching this result, I would say, okay. We don't want to create every line of code that's hard to make a simple word. So we start to look deeper at the code and to understand that if we can't change the user interface, don't change the kernel of the application. But unfortunately, the structure is not good enough because the user interface and the kernel of the product are mixed together. So to do such a job, to change the user interface, we need to rewrite about 80% of the code. And even another problem that we found looking deeper in the code, that the XML format give us a lot of trouble, because if we want to expand a new functionality, a new feature in the CAD application, in there we need to reparse the file, and then we get some backwards compatibility with the old drawing. Of course, the product at that time was not too much mentioned, so we have no problem with the back drawing at least one. So, but think about that. So, what was the solution of this? The solution that we found in paper 3 months was to manage the file using SQLite, to store all the data into the database. It was quite new things for a CAD application. Today, all the CAD application made the one is the IKEA, with an internal database, so that is a pre-made CAD application. So we decided to use SQLite. We found a new way to compute geometry. As I told you before, I'm quite lazy. I don't want to rewrite all the algorithms that make intersection, branches, things, and so on. So we find CPy, which is a package, a good way to have a line and another line to say, to mean the intersection, you can mean the point of the intersection of the geometry. As I told you, we upgrade to Qt interface, and we rewrite everything. We create a new structure for the code. So, let's go on that. Let's go deeper in SQLite. SQLite have a very nice thing, because you can have it in memory, or even you can store in the file, so you have both things. So, we say, okay, we can manage it in memory and then save the file, or why not? You can use it like a file. So we just move a SQLite file to store our drawing, to move our drawing around. It's embedded in Python, so we don't need to compile any new library. It's just there. You can just use it. And even it's cross-platform. Even it's Mac, like Linux, no problem at all. So we are very excited about that. And as you can see here, we use the keys. We think about to have more version of the same drawing in the same file. No CAD have this functionality. Because we can revision each entity and say, okay, at this step, if, I don't know if someone knows, you have some background in drawings, but when you have a mechanical company, for example, you can do a piece, a mechanical piece, and then you have to make some revision on this piece because for backward compatibility. So we manage this, and then with this database, it is possible to have an undo history forever, because we store in a table database, so we can go back to the first line. Each time we open the drawing, so we don't lose the undo history, no more. This is very important for a CAD package, because the time when you draw, the application crash, you lose your work. With the database, it's not possible, because each modification that you does the drawing is stored in the database. So if the program crash, your job is still there, you don't lose anything. That is quite a nice feature for a CAD package. So someone, this guy, say, are you sure that this works? Okay, let's some tests on it. So let's draw in the structure before, just three table. The new table, the entity table, and the relations table. Just the three table. And this one is the table for the entity. It appeals for the entity. So as I told you, use CP code. Yesterday I saw that CP code is not supported for Python 3. It's not good because we use it for compress the format. As you can see here, we have an ID that manages the unique constraints for each row. We have the entity ID that is the entity of the entity itself. we set the object, like a style, settings, okay, segment points, and so on. We can add more stuff there. This is a simple stuff. Okay, then go deeper in SymPy.
Why you use digits and not just why you use digits and not just use coordinates, which are easier to read and to
look, I don't need to read anything. I mean, I just store the information in database. And what we want is to have less space in the table as possible. So SymPy is the most at the time with this. I'm not a very, I have not a grand school of programming physics and stuff before, because this kind of company is, would you like to come and work with it? So I have not the ground in programming, so I just do everything by myself. So sometimes the choice that we made with what we asked for is not school background or again a lot of stuff, I mean a lot of information I get last year back on here and made me help me to do some stuff here. So that. Okay, SymPy is quite nice because it's a competitor in Agile a system, GAS, and hopefully we have a geometrical model that you can call. As you can see here, you have segment points, you can get an intersection, even for ellipse, you can ask the area of the ellipse and so on. So you don't need to rewrite everything, you just use that. And then, for measure, for different unit measure, SymPy have a model inside. So we have degrees, gradients, millimeter, feet. So we don't have to care about that because SymPy does all this stuff for us. Even PyQt, as you know, it's cross practical. We found a good idea that is Eric, and we use that for deploying our develop our application. And the main point for the PyQt for the cube graphic view and cube graphic scene that handle all the entities. So we don't have to care about the entity, just store it in the database, take it from the database, or put in the graphical user interface. And even the point star there was very nice. Because with these two lines of prompt, you just give the next you can do for this application. Only these two lines, no more. Okay. This one is to create a spec file. Here you know, this is the script that does all the job. This is the name. You can set the record from the application. All the files, the include parts that you need for the package. And of course, the application, the main application file, the .py file. And even when you run this, you get a .spec .spkz file, and then .spkz file, you call that file the build.py, and you get the executable ready. You can just go to the works. Of course, you have to copy some bitmap in your application, because the PyStyler doesn't do that work for you. Just to copy all and another feature that they have by installer is able to create binary file either for Linux and Mac. So with these two lines we get that all combined. Let's have a quick look of the new code structure. Okay, I didn't show you browser code structure. Now it's quite more organic because we have a generic one folder and an interface package. Here is for all the interface stuff. So all the and so on are all stored here. I'd like to have two different applications, because this generic stuff works a lot. You don't need this. You can just work with this. You can, the main application is here, is all in there. All commands are in there. All operation with files are in there. So if you need to do some batch operation, you can just include your Python script, let's say import application.py, and then use an access to that. Okay. We'll give you an example. And say open that document, give me the pointer of that document. And here we can apply all the new commands, create a segment and so on. Then when you have the application ready, you can say save the current file as EXR format. So you can just batch using this batch batch code to create, for example, EXR file. I mean. When we will have the DWG directory ready, we can do stuff operation between VXF and DWG file, all DWG file with the SWG files and so on. So we just need to have time to code. So let's start this script. Trouble with the all this stuff, even for complex programs. So we have the functionality. But if you open the game, it's fresh, okay? We lose 1 second to reload all the stuff, but it's in there. So, and there's no other program that works like that. Really?
Can you repeat the question?
Which one? If I can give, if you pixel the length of the line when I use this command. So if I want that this line is, for example, 10 millimeters, how can I do it? So, right now it's not possible, but you can create a segment. Just say here, I want from 0 to 0. You can go in this way, or sometimes when you start to just create a line, then you start to make a parallel of that line, and then fix the distance, and then you work with 2D programs that are used to work in that way. To change it over. So. I mean, we need to put the lines there, so the user can do it. Right now, sometimes
when I work the way, just get it started by. So we look at the intersects of the square in the bigger room. So it's quite important thing that the square must be inside of 5 meters.
So we even have a dimension. The slowness here to show the net. Square is cubed to simplify. Right now it has a little trouble. Because when we select the entity, the Qt interface gives us the entity that are not fraction, but each entity here has a bigger square, and when we pass it to rounds over, just highlight the entity. So you take care of the bounding box of that entity and give us the entity that overlaps with the bounding box. So we go that entity, we ask the SymPy to give us the intersection. So SymPy is quite slow, and it's so bad that we have this problem. All these people don't want this contribution, so a lot. And as you can see, the operation system that was created abroad is on Windows, but Linux is not bad, and you have to consider that all this transaction mostly comes, goes inside here. So, and even the country that uses the load of this problem, I would say Italy and Germany, Russia, and France. And very, very strange things that that is downloaded. So let's have a look at the roadmap for the first data release. Of course, we need to fix a lot of bugs. We need to finish the dimension with style, so to have a lot of possible stuff on the dimension. We manage functionality. And this is quite easy to improve because the functionality, you have just to give to the functionality the boundary of the area that you want to fill. Just say, okay, fill that area. So it will be easy to deploy this command. We need to fix the preview troubles. And what we remain, the biggest thing that we want to do is to have EWG write printed capabilities. That we will make with a library EWG, that is a GNU library, but bind it on Python. So it's nice. But we have some trouble to compile it on Windows machine. And she was the first one to be able to be able to so here is some feature that we have. I told you before we have unlimited undo revision history, incorrect export the different format data PG and DXF cross platform ability. There is not too much CAD that are really cross-platform. There was one that is a different CAD, but now it's different CAD or something like that. So we can with QT and C, cross-plus. I don't like it because it's very and sometimes I think, oh, maybe I can have that problem because there are a lot of people that work for that. And of course, the main feature that we have that is easy to extend because it's Python. So we can extend in the whole platform in the whole way that we need. So we can take a part of it and it's easy. So, more feature that we can introduce in package is manage groups. Actually, you can group entity only by layer, not by groups. And sometimes people need groups. I don't know why it's not enough. we can extend the mechanical feature. So we can need stuff like welding symbols, stuff like that. We would like to go in the architectural feature. The architectural feature was group and so on. And maybe it's right for the course. I have someone contact with some people that want to build an electrical cable on this, but just a few minutes anymore. And of course, we need some contribution to go on this project. We really need it. So, but the story goes on, and now we change just a bit. Finish the first step of the party part. The question for just.
Do you have questions for the community afterwards?
Yes, yes, of course. I want just to introduce what we have done to clarify more. Just to say why Python for these are very important. Because last year I had a very bad year because my company down the baby for a lot of months. And in October, I decided to leave my company and create my own company with its own decisions. I was a PSO engineer, the main PLM staff. I don't know if you know PLM, it's probably like cycle management. You take care of all the process of from the technical department to all the database staff. And we have this PLM system integrated with the CAD package, so we just use it. So, go very fast. I opened my own company that you can open your FTP parchment. I don't know if some of you know some of it. It's an open source API, we can entirely invite it. We started developing, me and my colleagues from the large company, we started building a new model that we call Open FTPLM. So we match the function right of that package, and we read all the information that we need from a drawing, and we put in an ERP system. I don't know who have done already anything like that. So we have built a full-feature PLM integration with Open ERP. We integrated the first one, it was a team design, it was my last company, T3.com, because we know very well the design. We work, I worked there for 8 years, so it's you know, mostly everything like that. So, and it allows you to directly write the product data into open air. So, if you're drawing, just click the, okay, you have to need to fill a little form to write information like description, code, project, and so on. And then you can just press the save button. And all this stuff goes into the server, and you can manage even the accuracy access to the save file. So I can take my file and say, okay, it's fine, but I can modify it and say that to all the company. Even PDF file was written when we say you save the training code. So all the company can benefit from this. This was a quite a good, it was quite difficult because we have a lot of new concept in that. We use a Keio framework, it's a Qt framework to read data from OpenERP. We're using some other RPC to communicate between the file application and the OpenERP server. We create a command server directly in Python. All this stuff are written in Python. So from the application, we call the command server that will put the OpenERP. So that's nice. And that's not easy to do such a stuff, even if you want to compile it. If I will buy install it, but we get some trouble and we need to buy Google Excel to grab the things done. So, timing. You have to know that the other guys that are working with me doesn't know Python, never print hello world, so never does that stuff. Of course, if you have a background of programming, it takes less than 4 months, just 1 people to work on that, and me in spare time, to get a full featured alpha version. So, com, so it's another PC, OpenERP, automated Python in 4 months, and another one to get the beta for testing. So now we are in production with one customer with the solution. So we start in January, now we are in production. It's amazing if you think to do it in another language. So there you just do to use the pieces that you need, put together the bug. So as I told you, Python is a real answer of all my working history since I met Fatima. So it's easy to learn, it's solid. No bugs, I never found a bug in Python in more than 2 years. It's amazing. you can choose between many either editor or not, but it's if you like it. I don't know. But really, you can find the like a clothes if you put in the same or shoes, that's very nice. At least there is always a model that helps you do your job. Or something little that is really not really, and even this cross platform. I think that this is a good chance for the future. So, let's thank you to be here, listening to me. Thank you to Python, of course, because it makes all of this possible and make me proud of it. And all the people that helped me on the net. Even with stupid things, sometimes with work and stuff. My wife, of course, was a... He didn't understand anything about Python, about programming, but you should listen to me. And organizing it here, that's also very great and helpful. And except for the NAFTA, as always. And here, for any questions or...
Let me ask. Thank you. I saw before that the common problem the syntax we're using that is not fine.
No.
Is there an ambition? It's not just the evil or the
no. Okay. Just a No. Is okay. This is an input box, and if you just type something, it gives you just repeat what you type. For instance, if you can, for example, so if you want, sometimes it happens that you want to remember something. So a length or something, someone. Just type it. Now, if you want to do an exact operation, let's use this symbol here. And the exact value.
Yes, I mean, draw a line here before that to be the line without any practices.
Yes, because I have to show you the code, but when you type here, the first thing that I mean, and you match between the block you have with the available comment. The match, if your match is equal, it's the comment. If there is no match, I just can't copy the
why it's not just right. Okay, that's more. I mean, you think this is more usable for the general level?
Yeah, of course. Yeah. If you want to do some Python stuff, you can just use the symbol there and you have Python. It's an example Python. There is another symbol, I made it more than 1 year ago and never used it. But when we start with this application, I made the kernel, I made all this functionality without a user interface, and the other guys in Holland bring all the user interface. Then he stopped to help us, and I take care of the user interface too, so it goes there. And there is another symbol that is this one. Use. And to what is exact and what is about for both the operation. The code, just to go the code from the source code. Okay. So if you have a look at it, I can show you that.
Yeah, so my question was also for command line.
Yeah,
I remember also application I used to a few years ago with a very strong command line interface, and I think it's very nice to have a Python.
Yeah.
But the most interesting thing is that you can easily remember the commands. So if you use a natural language interface,
yeah,
that you can simply talk with the application. It's very easy to remember.
Yeah.
So you can do it very technical, it works.
Yeah.
But it's not easy to remember.
Yeah.
And for the performance using the keyboard, it's very necessary to remember every command. Yeah. So if you have a construction word noun object, for example, you type draw a circle, mm-hmm. and then you hit with the mouse,
yeah.
and then to center of and the entity,
yeah.
so you can mix.
It works in this way.
This way, yes.
Yeah, you can.
I think it's very, very, very nice to have that.
Point. And you can just speak to
yes. Okay.
The point. So is, the input case from the command line to the graph algorithm. It mixed together and set the one. Okay, if there is another question, or if you want, I can show you the other application that you can share with us all. If you have another question, I'll find it here.
Can you talk about the command in three tabs? How would you approach the problem?
Okay, my focus was, the first time I mentioned Python was right now there are two, three projects that build the FreeDB cloud application. But this FreeDB application doesn't happen to me. So I say, to develop the 2D application, we did a very dramatic task here. Okay, so it's a good chance, I mean, it's a good race for you to achieve the result. So we need a very huge team that work there. But all this 2D product doesn't have it in the 2D, so I said, and the 2D application, I mean, the 2D drawing is the art, the drawing that you go, you know, to give to the people, to build the stuff. So, we have no plan right now to go to 3D. Even the points are described as two-dimensional points, not 3D points. So, because we want to focus on having a good 2D product, cross-platform, open source, could be a very, very nice thing for a lot of people. Now, and I can say that it's a good challenge if you do it like in the spare time. If you spend the time, or if you have time to design stuff, if you have spare time, like sometimes 1 hour in a week just to do some little things, and you forget everything. So, no, not for you. I was thinking I was looking for Panda 3D because it gives us lots of stuff to render the 2D sheet inside. But I have to do some checking. Even I don't have time now to do so much. So, I think it's me. But the other project, we use Eclipse. So we need to start the Eclipse. It takes some, but it's not the end. I don't like Eclipse at all. But the other guys like Eclipse. He does mostly the job.
Why don't you like it?
Oh, it takes too much time. Even for that. But it's quite nice. I mean, I have a lot of functionality with experiments. So, let me start the OpenRP server. Here, drawing that we store in the database and click the OK button. Here, start to download from the server all the file the application needs, put all the files inside the folder, and go to the CAD application and open the file, of course. So from here, as you can see, we have a lot of components. As you can see here, all the parts that are inside the folder. So in here, you can edit your parts, so you can put in stuff like raw materials, paper, finishing, even the description. You can see here the linked document of that. You can have more description, the same description, change description. You can even manage the workflow for this entity. So now it's a draft because you have drawn, then it can be confirmed. You can even do a new version of that drawing, so you can restore all of this stuff. What you can do even is curing, see, you see what's going on. is the previews are rendered from the inside of OpenERP, right?
You use a library for it? Or?
No, we store the image. We store the preview and the PDF file inside the database. When you just click on it, we render to the application. We ask to the database to give us the PDF or the bitmap, just go back. Saving this assembly here is quite a complex stuff. Because you have to ask the CAD application to give you all the components that you have here. Even each of these is a file. So you need to save all the file and all the relation between the file and the top file. So the operation that we made when we save this is quite complex. I mean, it's possible. It's not difficult, like it's small, not covered, but it takes a long time. And this CAD application here is not easy to work with because it has a very bad complex interface. So, for example, one project that we fetch, that they will be able to set each component as current, and we saw when we saved it. Because you can, now it's Italian, sorry. You make carry this component, and then in there we store the information related to that component that is different from each of this row. So we need to go in, read the information,
close,
go in, read the information, and out. And then all this information has to be stored in the server. So we manage this stuff too. Even the relation between documents and the relation between components. So all the stuff has to be packaged and push the server. And we get back here because with the com of this application, there is someone here very expert in com with Python, when you ask to the com, of the CAD package to make current the first one, when we finish all the job that we have done, we have to set the method to new variant. If you do that with this application with a python.com, it crashed. So we are forced to use C sharp to do only this operation with a com class. So to get three lines of code of com to do just this little stuff here. So the project here is structured. It structured quite well because we have the name class here is the base integration effort that creates a layer between all CAD application and the OpenERP. And then we create this integration here that is another layer of code between this layer here and the CAD application. So if we have to integrate or interact with another CAD application, we just need to write the code that is interfaced between the our code and the CAD application for less than 1,000 rows. So, we are very, it's very easy to do that. Even if we want to, another thing that we can do with this product is to integrate with OpenOffice, for example, to store a document, revision in that document, take care of it. Okay. So, it's quite powerful, this kind of tool, to manage documents. Would be a good way to do it. This is not right now published. The code is not right now published, but it will be due in the following month. It's going to be a time to go on the bazaar. Don't know. Okay. Any questions? just a little bit of structure of Python. Is designed to be, all of the command that we have built is designed to be improved very easily. Okay, so if you want to create a new command inside the application, you just need to create two files. One will be inside the command package here. I will show you a very, very simple line. But the structure is the same for even the complex command. Essentially, we derive from the base command, is the base class for the old command, okay? And we create the print command. Here you define what you need from the user. So what the user have to ask us, have to input to the system to create the information that we need from the user. In this case, the exact point is an exception, the Python exception, okay? And we store this. So in this case, we need a point from the user. Then we can set some default value. For example, as I showed you, when we fill it, we have the option that asks us if we want to make the trim one line, the other line, or both, or no, and so on. So we can put here some default value. I will show you more. This is quite simple because I have only one item in this. And then the message. The message is the message that is from the. It's not right now localized, but it has to be done. And we will do it here. And then the by command is when the user finishes his input. So in here, what we do is just to create a memory void. We get the value from the first element of the user interface, and then we ask to the document, the active document, to send the entity directly. So we create this entity, we save, and when we call this save entity, the entity will save in the database. So for a more complex example. Complex. You can see here, we accept here, we ask the user to give us an entity point, that is exactly an entity, we click upon an entity, to one entity, another entity. We ask the user to write some text, okay, and give us the length. Okay. As I told you here, we have some default value. We don't need any value for the first two elements of this, because the user need that the user select an entity. We can suggest the user to change the entity. But we can suggest the user to use both, that is the default value. Okay, so we think that the user mostly needs to both to make the data between two lines, so to use the two pieces. So, and this is the message that we brought. And the even radius of the arc that we are going to do was made with a different value that is there. In here the apply command is again very, very easy, because we just need to create the R, and then to store, we need to create the R, to modify the two lines, and to save all this modification. We use this form here, that is self-document start massive creation. This is a Google stuff, because when you upload, you made a lot of modification in the database. You say, I want to do this stuff, but I don't want to commit each stuff that I do. So we say, okay, we stop to automatically commit the information inside the database. It's common. We do all the stuff, and then finally, when we have made all the things that we have done, just commit. Okay, it's quite common for a database if you want to put very large amount of memory. Because the first time that we maybe we don't think about that, but we saw that we load some file, it takes very long time, so right? That's in there. And even this control is made to give information to the user that the number of value that the user has to input might be equal to 4. So, in case we need to create a fillet here, we have a whole implementation to do the fillet. So, we take the two entities. This can be input right now, because it's just an index of the list. So, it will be more nice if you put, for example, this or name, but you can see this way. So, we get the information from the first user, the input, and we get the value, that is the ID of the entity and the point, the ID of the second entity and the point that we store in the user interface. We get the geometric part, we get the entity, the two entities, we get the construction element of the entity, so we can do this construction element create the segment in memory. We do the same for the second. This is the way that we use to store the information inside the command. And with this information stored from the user interface, we just call the fillet in memory command, an object. And give us a fillet ready with all this information. So we did all the stuff of the job and put this argument inside the fillet. So here we have other stuff to create to recreate the fillet. And then as soon as we are done, we add all this entity that gives them, because this entity is the entity that we have modified. So the fillet command give us the two line modified, okay, treatment or not treatment, and then the new entity that is the R. So this is the way to be improved. I don't like it. I have done it. Very powerful way.